There are many examples of how the media misrepresents studies. For example, here are some recent headlines based on a real scientific study. Husbands who do more housework may have less sex. Want to have more sex? Men stop doing chores. Men not doing chores, having a lot of sex. These media headlines are based on a correlational study that measured the time and type of chores, masculine versus feminine, and the amount of sexual encounters. In the study, they found that couples who split the type of household chore, masculine versus feminine, reported 5 sexual encounters per month. However, when men completed approximately 17 hours of masculine type chores and women completed approximately 35 hours of feminine type chores, they had nearly 2 more sexual encounters per month. Chores, or types of chores, masculine versus feminine, and sexual encounters in this example. A variable is any characteristic that can vary across individuals or across time within the same individuals. And this is a correlational study because we are not manipulating any variables. Instead, we are just simply observing a mathematical relationship between 2 variables. In this case, chores, the number and type, masculine versus feminine, and the amount of sexual encounters. An important distinction in correlational studies is that they do not manipulate any variables. Instead, we're just measuring to see whether the variables are related. This differs from experimental studies, wherein researchers actually manipulate an independent variable and measure the effect on the dependent variable. We will cover these types of studies after looking at correlations.